참을 수 없는 탱크의 마력. 국내 최초의 탱크 전쟁, 월드 오브 탱크 코리안 리그. 오픈 시즌 챔피언 노아, 시즌 1 챔피언 아르테, 그리고 이제 이 모두를 평정할 최후의 전쟁, 월드 오브 탱크 코리안 리그 시즌 2 더 파이널. 우승팀은 워게임인 넷 e스포츠 리그 그랜드 파이널 진출. 과연 모든 것을 가져갈 끝판왕은 누가 될 것인가? 이지스, 다사다난트, 바이퍼스, ARPS를 꺾고 결승에 진출한 디펜딩 챔피언 아르테. 제규어, ARPS, 드라키, 바이퍼스를 차례로 격파. 빼앗긴 챔피언의 자리를 되찾아오겠다. 노아.
만나야 될 팀이 만났다고 생각하시겠지만 저희는 절대 그렇게 생각하지 않고요.
아르테가 올라온 게 더 기쁜 건 저희가 결승에서 진 빚이 아르테한테 유난히 맞기 때문에.
하지만 아직 객관적으로 보나 뭐 저의 주관적으로 보나 저희가 약간 더 우위에 있다는 거.
분명 저희가 지면서도 배우는 게 있었고 그리고 그거를 저희의 장점을 흡수를 하고 단점을 좀 상쇄시키는 그런 효과가 있었다고 생각을 해요.
그런 독이 될 수 있다는 생각은 사실 세 번째 붙었을 때 이제 버렸고요.
아르테 팀 거 분석하다 보면은 아르테 팀은 별로 시즌 1이랑 시즌 2랑 달라진 것 같지가 않아요.
오히려 노아가 저희한테 세 번 져서 그것 때문에 아르테 공포증이 생겼지 않았을까 싶습니다.
정말 말할 수 없을 만큼 좋겠죠. 많이 기뻐서 제가 평소에 잘 하지 않던 감정 표출을 마음껏 할지도 모를 것 같아요.
저희가 노력한 만큼 거둔다고 생각을 하고요.
돈, 명예, 그리고 우리가 그토록 바라왔던 아르테 팀에 대한 복수.
반면 걱정되는 건 너무 그 벽 같은 걸 느끼지 않나.
예상 스코어는 당연히 저희가 4대 0이죠.
4대 1 예상하고요.
당연히 4대 0입니다.
4대 0 내지는 4대 1 정도가 될 것 같은데.
다들 끝나고 디프리도 가셔서 재밌게 노시하니까 4대 0으로 빨리 끝내겠습니다.
뭐 스코어가 중요합니까? 왜 저희 아르테 A만 봐도 손가락을 부들부들 떨게 만들어드리겠습니다.
지금 아르테가 있는 그 자리 저희가 다시 올라가도록 하겠습니다.
좋은 경기 합시다.
기억나시죠? 패패 승승승 다시 한번 느끼게 해드리겠습니다.
노아 힘내세요.
이제 피할 수 없는 지상 최대의 싸움이 시작된다. 월드 오브 탱크 코리안 리그 시즌 2 파이널. 아르테 대 노아, 노아 대 아르테. 디펜딩 챔피언과 초대 챔피언의 진검 승부가 지금 시작됩니다.
Greetings from Seoul, Korea, and welcome to the finals of World of Tanks here, Korea, at GOM EXP. Tasteless and Artos is here. How you doing, man?
Tasteless, I am really, really stoked for this match. A rematch from the Season 1 finals. The open season champions going against the Season 1 champions.
Yeah.
It's like a fairy tale, Tasteless.
Well, you couldn't really ask for a better finals here.
Mother Goose couldn't have made a better story than this one.
These two teams now facing off here, and no matter what, we're going to have one team that will now have two championships, crowning them, hands down, undisputable, the best team in Korea.
That is correct. And you know what? If Arete ends up winning this one, as Calpeef says,
they will fear the letter A.
They will fear the letter A.
I love that, by the way.
Yes.
We're going to be bringing out our teams here shortly for an interview. But if you're just now joining us, World of Tanks has been out in Korea for a little bit over a year now. Mm-hmm. And it's been huge to see how these teams have actually developed. Now, we're going to take a quick look here at the team intro videos before we go any further. But yeah, the way these guys have developed has really been incredible.
T3에 올 때까지 따돌리기가 쉽지 않습니다.
네. 게다가 거기에 돌리지가 된다. 여기까지 좋은데.
집에 돌아가 있으니까 맞는 거예요.
네, 이거 스파이지 되죠.
이상구.
여기서 빌린 받아갑니다.
1팀 할게, 1팀 할게!
마무리.
네네. 제발
거기서 나도 돌려라.
망했어요
이거는.
아 이거 정말
망했어요. 야 대장전에
세 발을 연달아 꽂아.
All right, and now we're going to bring out our first team, Arete, the champions of last season, led by their team captain on the right, Kauthi.
The greatest team in Korea, if you ask me, Tasteless.
I think they're the favorites coming into here, Artosis.
Have to say that. Noah has had no success against them so far.
No, it was funny, too, because we really expected Noah to do a lot better than they actually did. And now we're going to introduce our second team, the champions of the GOM TD Open for World of Tanks. It is going to be the team Noah. Now, they were formerly known as Draki. And let's take a closer look. And that is Noah there. As I said earlier, they were a member of the Draki family. Draki, I believe, had three teams in the Open, if my memory serves me correctly.
Yes,
it was the Vipers and then the original Draki. This Draki version was Rebellion of the Hatchling, right? Now, after they won the Open season, they changed their team to Noah and became independent.
I think that was probably the right move for them. Still very close friends with the other Draki teams, but you know, they are head and shoulders above them, and they need to represent themselves.
Well, so we're going to see if they get their revenge here today. Now we're going to go ahead and go to the interview here with our two team captains. It's Kauthi on the left and Noah on, or Evenfall, excuse me, on the right.
안녕하세요.
네, 송진혁 선수, 어젯밤 좋은 꿈 꾸셨나요?
아니요, 좋은 꿈을 꾸진 못했고요. 그냥 아무 생각 없이 잘 잤던 것 같아요.
아, 그게 좋은 거죠, 동.
네. 네,
오늘 많은 분들이 아랫대를 응원하러 강남 코믹스 스튜디오에 찾아와 주셨어요. 이분들께 감사의 인사 부탁드릴게요.
아, 좀 바쁜 시간 와중에도 이렇게 저희의 마지막 결실을 지켜보러 와주신 분들께 정말 무한한 감사를 느끼고요. 네, 그거에 상응하는 저희들의 멋진 경기력을 보여드리겠습니다. 감사합니다.
I'm very thankful for all the fans that showing up, that showed up today at the studio. And for the fans, he's going to try to show some great matches.
빼앗긴 편편 자리를 되찾아오겠다고 엄포를 놓았습니다. 아랫대는 오늘 노아를 상대로 어떠한 필승 전략을 준비해 오셨나요?
아, 솔직히 말해서 저희가 좀 자신이 없어요. 노아한테 질 자신이 없어요. 아니, 나는 노아한테 진 팀들을 이해할 수가 없어. ARPS 대체 뭐 하는지도 모르겠고. 여러분, 노아는
I can't understand why teams lose to Noah.
확실히 보여줄게. 오늘은 저희들 노아가 이기 어떻게
And I'm going to show how it's done to beat them here today.
강하게 도발 역시 송준혁 선수다운 말씀해 주셨는데요. 끝으로 송지현 선수 하면 이보다 더 강한 도발, 도발이 인상적이잖아요. 노아에게 초초초 울트라급 도발 한번 제대로 한마디 해주시죠.
이게 제가 도발하는 게 준비하는 게 아니에요. 근데 제가 저번 시즌에 노아를 어떤 오브젝트로 표현한 게 있어요. 그게 무서워서 피하는 게 아니라 더러워서 피하는 거잖아요. 네. 저는 더러워서 피했지만 만날 수밖에 없었기 때문에 저희가 잘
Last 치우겠습니다. season he compared 감사합니다. Team Noah to
네, 역시 강합니다. 다음은 노아의 송호선 선수.
To an object he doesn't want to repeat here today.
네, 아, 네.
But he feels the same way as that from last 모시죠? season. And he just wants to throw away Team Noah.
노아를 응원하는 팬들이 엄청납니다. Yes. 추운 날씨에도 경기장에 함께 해 주신 팬들에게 한 마디 해 주세요.
아, 정말 요새 날씨가 약간 추운 그런 날씨에도 불구하고 이렇게 많은 분들이 응원하러 와주시고 구경하러 와주셔서 정말 감사하게 생각하고 있고요. 그만큼 좋고 어떤 멋지고 빠르고 그런 경기로 보답해드리도록 하겠습니다.
I'm also 네. thankful for all the fans that showed up here today, even though it's very
네,
cold outside.
아랫대의 주장님은 어제 별 나름 꿈 없이 그냥 무덤하게 지냈다고 하시는데 송호성 주장님은 어젯밤에 무엇이 보이던가요?
아, 사실 저희가 예전에도 한번 말씀드린 적이 있는데 원래 경기 전날에는 연습을 안 하는 편인데 어제는 저희가 연습을 했거든요. 그러니까 사실 아무리 자신감을 표출하려고 해도 저희가 아레테한테 상대 전적이 밀리는 건 사실이고 그래서 연습을 지금까지 하면서 계속
Team Noah, are we really
아레테라면 이렇게 하지 않을까 아레테라면 이거보다 더 잘하지 않을까 스스로 채찍질하면서 연습을 좀더 하다
But
보니까
we gathered
감정이 깊었었는데
because they lost recently.
그만큼 잠은 푹 잘 수 있었고 오늘 아침에 딱 일어났을 때 기분이 되게 좋은 걸 보니까 왠지 오늘 경기 결과도
But we also had a good night's sleep.
매우 좋을 것 같네요.
And we had a good feeling 네, making
노아 팀은 최근 중요한 경기에서 유독 아랫대 팀에게만은 약한 모습을 보이셨어요. 하지만 오늘은 기필코 챔피언의 자리를 되찾아오겠다고 하신 만큼 아랫대를 쓰러뜨릴 무시무시한 전략 당연히 준비해 오셨겠죠?
Did you prepare any specific strategies for today?
저희가 예전에 아랫대에게 질 때는 분명 아랫대의 약점이나 강점을 파악할 수는 있겠지만 좀 저희 팀 자체의 약점을 고치기가 상당히 어려웠는데 많은 분들이 이번 시즌 노아는 확실히 뭔가 달라졌다라고 평가를 해주시는 게 분명 그 약점을 저희가 보완을 했다고 생각을 하고 있어요.
We lost to Arete because
이번 결승전만큼
they knew our weaknesses.
저희가 아르테를 이기는 것만 아니라 앞살할 수 있는 그런 경기를 할 수 있을 거라고 생각합니다.
But we did that this season.
끝으로 송호선 선수 조금 전에 송진엽 선수가 노아 팀에게 지는 걸 이해할 수 없다 이런 말씀을 하셨어요. 이런 말을 듣고도 가만히 있는다면 노아가 아니죠.
아, 뭐 도발 같은 거는 사실 제가 그렇게 크게 신경을 쓰고 있지는 않은데 원래 스스로의 실력에 자신이 별로 없으면 그렇게 상대방의 감정을 흐트려뜨리는 그런 도발을 많이 하는 편이거든요. 그러니까 저희는 확실하게 실력으로 보여드리도록 하겠습니다.
아, 네, 양팀
To Calthew's comment. I think he's
네,
saying those words because he's not confident.
지금까지 경기에 앞서 양팀 주장 선수들의 출사표를 들어봤습니다. 시작 전부터 불꽃 튀는 입담으로 분위기가 한껏 달아오르고 있는데요. 자, 그럼 월드 오브 탱크 시즌 2 결승전 첫 번째 경기 1세트 맵과 시작 위치를 정하도록 하겠습니다. 동전을 던져 앞면이 나오면 아랫대가 뒷면이 나오면
And
노아가
now we're go to the coin toss or toss.
대한 선정권을 갖게 됩니다.
Let's go right now. Heads or tails.
Well, you had this rigged from the beginning, so why don't you tell me?
It's heads. All right, now you go. You're gonna go tails.
던져 주세요.
Yeah, I guess so.
네, 앞면이 나왔습니다. 저희 심판분들은
heads.
누가 던지든 앞면이 나왔네요.
I'm so good, man.
이렇게 해서 아랫대가 오늘 경기 1세트 맵과 시작 위치에 대한 선정권을 갖게
right
되었습니다. 송진엽 선수, 오늘의 첫 번째 대결이 펼쳐질 전장은 어디입니까?
엔스크 북쪽입니다.
네, 이렇게 해서 결승전 1세트 맵은 엔스크로 결정되었고 진영은 아랫대 팀이 북쪽, 노아 팀이 남쪽으로 정해졌습니다. 여러분, 오늘 결승전 기대되시죠?
Now let's
네,
think about this, Artosis. We actually had, I believe this was actually the day that you were out of town, but Noah was the team that I cast and where not a single shot was fired. They captured the base so fast.
Yeah.
And they were starting in south in that position.
Mm-hmm.
Now obviously Arte has reviewed those games, but I'm curious to see what they have in store here on this map, which Noah's performed beyond just that game and several other games we've seen with them. They performed quite well.
Yeah, certainly. I think there's no possibility of any maps where no shots will be fired here. These teams both way too good.
The other team was clearly just outmaneuvered. And
Yeah.
They juked and jived around him.
I mean, unless they send in their head negotiator and he's the best. there's no way.
By the way, come down to our studio Entry is free. As you can see, it is packed here. This is about as packed as it ever gets down here at the GOM TV studio.
Yeah,
we are literally at maximum capacity here.
I think this is basically the packed, most packed it's been. That one special night where we gave away all
on
the gifts and the chicken.
Right?
And
beer, chicken, and pizza.
Yeah, yeah, like a couple
might
days
have
after.
Had a few more people than this, but I mean,
maybe.
It's
hard to say.
We literally can't get many more people in here. If there's a fire
we'd
in
have
here,
to start stacking
fire in
them.
Here, everybody dies, basically. Yeah. I mean, it is jam-packed.
Well, not you and I. We're smart. We, like, jump on top of everyone's
right.
heads and
we're
run
gonna
out.
We're going to climb on the stuff on the ceiling
for
and get out of here.
It would be like that scene from The Simpsons when they're getting
upgraded
to what
the audience doesn't know is we have a fireman pole over there towards the bathroom that we use on commercial break. So that's how we get out of here.
We have a slide into the subway system.
That's right. But everybody else would be screwed.
Yeah.
So your predictions here going into this.
Arete wins it 4-1.
I'm saying 4-2.
4-2.
But it probably is going to be a 4-1.
Yeah.
I want it to go more than a 4-1. I want it to be a 4-2 or 4-3.
Well, I'd like it to
I'd
be
want
very
it to be
close.
I just don't know if that's actually going
like
to be the
case
here.
I'd like to be closer, like a 4-0 that you just completely don't expect, like completely
like Noah 4-0s
disrupted.
Or something?
Like
that would be
the
cool.
T1s come in and take out the T8s and like just
they spin
crazy.
Around them too fast.
Yeah.
Again, it is a best of seven. Now, if you haven't watched World of Tanks, and you're wondering how exactly does this work, it is a 7v7. Each team gets 42 tier points.
Mm-hmm.
They can pick any tank up to tier 8. We don't let them go to tier 9 or tier 10 because Wargaming.
Well,
we all
those tanks get silly.
Those tanks are actually just too strong, and then it becomes kind of a weird matchup. We could have, like, two level 10 tanks and a bunch of weird
you don't want to do
lower level tanks.
This is better. It's more
yeah, this format's better because, you know, a tier 7 or a tier 6 can still put up a fight against a tier 8 at least.
Yeah.
So normally what we see is 5 tier 8s and then 2 tier 1s.
Yeah, in fact, this season that's the only thing that we've seen. And
in the Open and then in season 1 we had... Yeah.
A little bit
I
of
would
artillery
say more variety.
Play. Yeah, especially the open season. We saw a lot of artilleries, a lot of tier 2s, 3s, sometimes 4s. It's kind of interesting.
Yeah, but now that the game's developed, at least the meta game here has developed, it's gotten more to tier 8s and tier 1s. So here are the current ranking points in the circuit right now. As you can see, Noah with a small lead here.
Yeah, rightfully so because they did do so well in two seasons. Now, Arete, if they win this, they should be taking...
They will be the usurpers.
Yeah, and that means that they get to take over because that'll just be another 150
now,
for Noah.
Let me highlight here. Top four teams here. Noah, formerly Draki, the Rebellion of the Hatchling.
Yeah.
Number three here was Draki. They were in the finals of the Open.
Yep.
The sister team to what is now Noah. And then the Vipers, another Draki team.
Yep.
So Arete kind of stuck in between a really Draki dominant
that's right.
clan here
and
in Korea.
If you actually look at it, like for instance the Vipers, they just lose to Noah every time. That's who knocks them out of the brackets.
Yeah,
like,
it's
I think
true.
Every single season.
And it's funny too because ARPS is a close ally of Arete.
Yes, they are. You can really see which teams are rising to the top, who their play partners are, and
you basically have two rivalries right now.
The
Arete and ARPS, and then the Draki family. Now here's a closer look at Arete. Now with Arete, I want to highlight definitely watch for Pig Thief and Cow Thief. Cow Thief is a team leader. He's the one we saw interviewed.
Mm-hmm.
Pig Thief, he's the puller. He's the guy that's moving all over the map. Don't forget about Christina as well.
Yeah, Christina.
Togi has also done very some very strong plays here.
Look, every single one of these players is a giant in World of Tanks Korea.
Tusu was playing the T1, correct? He was one of the T1s that actually got several T1 kills off.
Sometimes Tusu does use the T1, I believe, but not always. So, you know, a lot of times we see Afi in the T1 and Sod in the T1.
Yeah, that's true.
And
these guys have a lot of rotation on roles here.
Yeah.
As far as which it's who plays what tanks.
Generally speaking, though, Cow Thief is going to use a heavier tank. Pig Thief is going to use probably the fastest tank out of anyone.
AMX 1390.
A lot of times, sometimes a T69, or if they're all using heavies, he'll use maybe an AMX 5100, which is a bit faster. It's just... Pig Thief needs the mobility. Cow Thief kind of sits in the same place a lot of the time.
And you got to keep in mind, guys, when you have seven people on a team and you're all talking you know, on microphones to each other, communication is essential. Mm-hmm. You can't have everybody talking at once. So Kathy does generally give all the calls, as does Evenfall over here at the top. Evenfall, by the way, normally playing the T1.
He, in fact, always plays the T1, and he is oftentimes the first player to die. He is the T1 that goes in the more dangerous area a lot of the time, and this allows him to speak with his team more and direct them more.
So he's, unlike Kathy, Kathy's a bit more hands-on, wants to engage, get some kills.
Yes.
Evenfall is really...
he's the only team captain like that, in fact.
He's like the mastermind behind all the plays here from Noah, and it's served them quite well. They've done so far better than any team in World of Tanks in Korea. I mean, they didn't win last season, but they won the first, they won the Open, and then they got second last season. So they win here today. I mean, you really can't challenge challenge Arte with that and say Arte might be better.
Yeah, that's it's so true.
I would say there's not as much star power here on for the rest of the Noah team.
It is a team game, and that's kind of, you know, it's interesting to see the differences between these two teams, where it's like a bunch of badasses on Arate and then like this team unit. The thing is, it's not like Arate doesn't function as a team, it's just a very different way that they go.
Arate is kind of like the Ninja Turtles or something, like we know which weapons each guy fights with.
Like that.
The Team Noah is kind of like the Borg.
They don't
or something.
Stand out so much. This is a good way
to look at it.
This
is a great example.
It's Ninja Turtles versus the Borg.
Yeah. That's the best way to sum it up here. Mm-hmm. Now, with Arate here, too, you got to keep in mind the different play styles. Arate and Noah are both, I would say, on the aggressive side. We did see Arate turtle, I believe, in one series against the Vipers. Is this correct? But the rest of the games, they actually just came out shots firing. Noah was a little bit more conservative playing against the Vipers. But then again, you know, the series against the Vipers, Noah just waited a little bit, and then eventually Sunglove called for the team to rush somewhere and everybody died. So,
By the way, if we take a look at these stats, you can see that overall Arate has gotten better. But I guess what is very interesting here is the difference in travel distance. You can see that they're even more mobile than they were in the previous season.
And to point this out, too, all the teams were incredibly not mobile in the Open.
Yes.
And so to see this improve over times here, and now season one, even into season two, to see mobility continuing to grow, is a sign that these guys are much more equipped to play World of Tanks. Since I think this the Open season might as well have been called World of Turrets.
Yeah. World of Nexus Defense. And you can see here as well with Team Noah, they have been more mobile. They've done a lot better this season so far. They've really been quite dominating this season. We have a different format this season as well with the group stage in that round of eight into a round of four bracket. So, you know, they had a little bit better time getting here to the finals.
Yeah. Noah, I'm curious because part of me just says Arte should dominate here.
Yeah.
Arte had a tougher group. And Noah, you know, their group was incredibly difficult, but Arate dominated so much. But at the same time, you know, if Noah actually does overcome this year, Arate, that makes him undisputed, untouchable.
Well, let's take a look. Ooh, look at this cute little graph here with the tank distribution. The increase, you can see that Arate's tank stayed very much the same, a little bit more IS-3 usage in Season 2. And... not too surprised to see
I'm curious with these stats, how much of this depends on which maps were picked as well?
Well, I think that's a big part of it.
Yeah.
You know, we've had a lot of games on city maps against kind of turtly teams, and you can see that both teams increased their usage overall of IS-3s, and there was actually a pretty big increase in AMX 5100s for Noah.
Now, a lot of the tank selection, actually basically all the tank selection, does boil down to what kind of map they're on. The first map is going to be Ensk. Ensk is a map that early on we were saying you could turtle it out on very easily, but I think the Koreans have gotten much better at aggressive play here. We're going to have Arate here at the north and Noah here at the south.
And with 24 sets played, we see that the north actually has an inferior win rate.
Yeah.
But Arate, they have a strat, and they're going to go ahead and use it. Now, will it be rushing down the center? Because we see that a lot from the north.
Yeah. And also actually from the south as well, we've seen a lot of center pushing.
Yeah, we do.
The problem is you can't both go through the center.
Yeah.
Once one guy takes the center, the other team has to go back and try to defend that.
I think a big part of that south win rate is from the earlier seasons where you just turtle over on the left-hand side of the map as the ball.
Yeah.
And that was a very powerful move, but it's not used as much anymore.
Now, if you take a look on the map here, the left side where the structures are, that bottom left box-like shape that's made out of those structures is a key point for camping, for hiding out, as well as the two structures you can see over there in the upper left, used to kind of hide behind. Mm-hmm. So we'll see what kind of game this turns out to be. Occasionally, games on Ensk are very short, and other times we even end up with draws. Now we're going to go on to the tank selection.
Here we go. The T1s, of course, will be picked up first by both sides. And then we can get started on the more interesting ones.
And those T1s, both teams will send one to the left and another to the right to spot. Mm-hmm. Use the radio to see if they can see any tanks and signal the rest of the team. And they do spot them. Now we do have Arate with two IS-3s. The response pick here from Noah is an IS-3 and an MX-5100.
Well, look, this is going to be all heavies. You see Pig Thief grab an IS-3. That means that these guys are serious about some city play, Tasteless.
Yeah, this may mean we'll see the train track in the center of the map ignored, but we'll have to see.
Yeah, I mean, they still could try to go up there and all kind of protect each other. We'll see about that coming up. So we have both teams just going for a bunch of IS-3s and MX-5100s.
So there's really only two tanks here, the IS-3 and the MX-5100, if you count out the T1, which is just a spotter tank. These are all heavy tanks, strong on urban maps, a lot of firepower here.
And you can see there's a slight difference. More MX-5100s for Noah, more IS-3s for Arate, and I would say that means that Arate is a little bit more likely to be the aggressor here.
I think you're right. Well, we're going to have to find out exactly how this game turns out in a little bit here. As the match is ready to start here, game number one here in the finals of World of Tanks, Korea. All right, it's time for game number one here. Again, Arate is slightly more IS-3 heavy. Noah, slightly more AMX-5100 heavy. Noah here at the south, and Arate, the defending champions here at the north.
What will their strategy be? It's going to come together quite quickly here. We do see Noah actually going towards that box at the bottom left.
Yeah, and it does appear that Arate is actually going to potentially go for the train tracks over here. But it looks like Arate is actually going to go for a rush
because
they are not slowing down at all, man.
Yeah, this is a rather quick rush, and it's not even down the train tracks. It's to the side of the train tracks.
I honestly was expecting Noah to do this, not Arate. But
yeah.
Let's see what happens here.
And some shots are fired. No one's hit quite yet. Arate continuing to push downwards. Noah's going to have to fall into a new position here once they realize what's going on. I feel like they already know.
Now, and Arate World is in position. We see the rest of Noah coming around here. But we do have a counterattack coming up here through the one file here.
Yeah, Christina taking some big damage so far. Togi hitting Peak Thief there from behind, but no real damage dealt.
We do have Noah's tanks coming around here from that might be hitting Arate here from behind in a second here. Now, the base capture has begun here. And there's only 23 seconds right now for Noah to do something to deny this.
Oh, a beautiful strategy. Notice Arate holding that street and three tanks on the flag. That gives them so little time to work with. Christina taking a lot of damage, though.
All right, they did take out that one tank. That bumps it up to 37 seconds for them to recapture that base right now. Arte World exchanging fire with Nano. Nano now taken out as Noah is cleaning up that base capture.
That's right. This rush strategy from Arate absolutely not working out so far. Cow Thief and Togi trying to bring it back. Big Thief holding the side, but Candy comes around with a strong shot.
And with Arate backing up now, note both teams do still have a T1 here. So it's right now at 3-4 here when you subtract the Tier 1 tanks that are used to spot here.
Well, right now, Noah, they want to get around here and clean up some more tanks if possible. Having only lost one heavy, they're in a gigantic lead at the moment. Arate in some trouble.
Shio Pop, it could be taken out. We have Pig Thief coming around the corner here.
Ooh.
And Red Bull taking a serious blow as well. Now we do have, for a second there, the base capture had started there for Arate. But it looks like they're bringing the T1 up here to spot now.
Uh-oh, Arty World coming after Pig Thief. Pig Thief hits him straight in the face.
We have the T1 coming over here to hit Arty World.
Oh, and down Pig Thief goes. But you know what? He takes someone out with him. Cow Thief from behind right now.
You want to watch for Artie World here. He's going to come down this alleyway. God, he's very low in HP. And the T1X is drawing fire.
Oh, and down he goes. Red Bull taken out as well. What has happened here? Arete has fought back.
Yeah, Arete played that beautifully, but there's still a base capture over here. I can't imagine that this will be pulled off because he has about a minute 20, so we should just assume this T1's going to be picked off here.
Yeah.
I got to say, if that had been captured, I think, a little bit sooner, mm-hmm. we would have had a different story since Arete did not have anything to defend this. But this one final tank, the T1, it is physically impossible for that tank to win against a T1 and 2 tier 8 tank. So
LB will be taken out in just a moment here. No biggie.
Togi actually whipped that. Okay, there we go. GG. Game number one goes to Arete.
Okay, so they rushed up. It failed. They lost more tanks than their opponents, and they still ended up taking that match. That was a crazy firefight there in the end. It was like the end of any 90s action movie where there's just this giant shootout. And you don't even know
somewhere
what's happening.
Somewhere Bruce Willis is almost bleeding to death.
Yeah, and that was Team Arete. They were Bruce Willis in that.
They were.
And at the end of the day, they threw Noah off the roof.
They did. Now, the sequel's coming out here in game number two. Does Bruce Willis die in that one?
No. Probably gets glass in his feet, but that's fine. That was crazy. That was really impressive by Arete that they still won, even though their rush strategy didn't end up working. They were down an entire tier 8 tank. And in kind of a funny position at the end.
Well, it's funny, too, because at the start, their rush strat was working. I mean, we're talking about...
Yeah, it looked like
19 seconds, I think, or 21 seconds, something like that. And it got stopped. And from there, I thought, okay, well, now Noah just wins, right?
Yeah.
They put these important tanks in a location. They didn't quite pull off. They almost did. They almost pulled off essentially the strategy that Noah beat that other team with in the last season. They tried that strategy on them. It almost worked, but... Noah denied it, but yeah, it was the firefight. It was the way that Arete was maneuvering throughout the city there to really get those tanks out of position. And when I talk about that, it's really all about where the opposing team's tank turret or turrets are pointing. If you can come around a corner and they suddenly have to shift that, 180 degrees to hit you, that's how you're going to win that. And that's what Arete is very good at, is outmaneuvering their opponents. They are a mobile team, and they know where to strike and when to do it.
Thing is, that's also something that you can say up against Noah. If Noah was facing anyone else, that's what we would be saying about
them.
That's
true. That's
so true. So it's crazy to see the two go against each other, but I do like that Arete, they brought the heat that time.
I also like that game was not one-sided. It was actually quite close. It came down to the very end. Mm-hmm. Artie World was low on health. They got him out of position. Boom. Goodbye, Artie World. Now you have two Tier 8 tanks. If they just take you head-on against your one Tier 8 tank, it's a game of math.
It is a game of math at that point. More tanks beats less tanks when they're the same tanks.
Yeah. 2v1, it's pretty straightforward.
Mm-hmm. Well, just some stats here on IS3 usage. You can see, statistically speaking...
I didn't know Kalthi played the IS3 as much as...
Do you know what?
Or actually, I mean Pick Thief, excuse me, not Kalthi.
Yeah, on city maps, when they don't want a medium or a light, he normally grabs the IS3. Now, if you actually take a look here, with the time selected versus the stats and whatnot, I feel like Noah is actually better at the IS3.
That is true. Can you consider that they've nearly doubled the amount of IS3 picked tanks
here? Yeah,
yeah. Now we're taking a look at who plays the AMX 5100 mostly.
And I would definitely say this goes to Arete if you look at
those Christina
stats.
Well, Christina, Nano, or Christina especially.
Yeah, Christina is like the tank on the side that gets all the kills. Like, you forget that he's around and then just he kills stuff.
You forget that he's a guy, man. That ID, Christina.
Yeah, I want to call him her or she.
She. No, Christina's very good. I wonder where he got that ID from. I wonder if that's like the name of his girlfriend or maybe like
Christina Aguilera.
Yeah.
That's my guess.
Genie in a bottle, baby.
You rubbed me the right way.
This guy's a genie in a tank, as far as I'm concerned.
Ooh. Well, he granted my one wish by winning that match.
Oh, yeah. Now we're going to go on to map number two. And we'll get to that in a minute here. It doesn't look like the opposing team has selected that map just yet. Mm-hmm. Or the losing team, I should say, has selected that map just yet. So that will be Noah picking that.
And just some more stats for you guys. There's so many stats that you can get out of World of Tanks. If you're a stats junkie, this is your game.
Yeah. This is definitely a game where you can throw a bunch of numbers around. Do some fantasy World of Tanks.
Yep.
So, you know, I do think Noah can still take a few games up Arete. I don't know if they can win coming up from that last game, because that last game was a lot about thinking on your feet.
Yeah.
Thinking on your treads, if you will.
Yeah. I still think that they're going to be able to take at least a game, maybe two. But I'd be actually surprised if this goes all the way to seven, to be honest. I think Arete is too strong.
All right.
Which I feel bad, because this team is like what a team should be.
Yeah.
But Arete is like...
Well, you know what it is? It's like Arete has the personality, and I think they have this aggressive, fun playstyle. But Noah, the way that they operate and communicate, Noah, it looks more like what an actual pro team should be.
Noah's like a well-oiled college basketball team where it's like they work as a unit. They've taken their coaching very well. They're all people that you're like, you know what? These guys might go right into the NBA and do a good job.
But
whereas Arete is a team of five Dennis Rodmans.
Yes, that's...
Well, seven Dennis Rodmans. Five Dennis Rodmans
and
two
T1s. Yes. All right. Our next map is going to be Himmelsdorf, which is German for Sky Village.
Yes.
If my German serves me correctly.
I generally like to call it town, but I mean,
you know,
villages are fine. Translation tastes.
Sky City. Sky City would be an overstatement, though.
Yeah, certainly.
We'll leave that in a Star Wars.
No, it looks kind of like a city when you
really
think about it.
Well, you know, it depends. You don't know if that's just the downtown, and actually the rest of it's pretty rural and boring, you know.
Yeah, but I mean, cities can be pretty small. There's cities that have like 30,000 people in them.
That's true. Those are called really crappy cities.
Yeah.
Into this game here. Again, this is an even more so urban map than our previous one. It's a lot of hallways, not a lot of open area. There is a chapel in the center right on the high ground. We usually see both T1s. This is like the early game here. We'll see both teams send a T1 up the hill.
Yes.
And occasionally we'll see a T69 accompany that. We have seen an AMX D100 accompany that, although
yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah, sometimes.
I don't know why. It didn't seem like it's a good build to open up the game
yeah.
with.
Yeah. I don't care for it so much. Like a T69, I can totally see it. You know, there's a little bit of metagame going around with what you do on that hill.
Yeah.
It's normally not that much, though,
because
to be honest.
Because if you get a kill on that hill, then it makes the whole rest of it forces that other team to start defending, and the other team naturally begins to attack in. Okay, so we have the T1s picked here, standard openings here. And now Noah's going to go with the IS3 and AMX 5100s. Now, I think you'd agree with me, Artosis. We will probably just have IS3s and AMX 5100s as we saw in the last game. It should be actually perhaps even an identical tank pick to the last game.
It definitely could be. We could see a T69, though, on either side or both sides as well. That is a possibility. As soon as you see Pig Thief grab that IS3, that tells me it's going to be all heavies.
All right, final tank pick. Now we'll lean towards IS3 or AMX 5100. Noah does go with the AMX 5100. Let's see if Arete mirrors that or if they try to pick and lean that more to the IS3.
Well, that's what they did last time.
And there
they
it is.
Do it again.
Okay, so.
Same exact tank lineup for both teams.
Nothing but heavy tanks.
In
that
fact,
makes sense on a heavy map.
Same players playing the tanks as well.
Yep. Mirror matchup, but different map.
Uh huh.
Now, you always want to go with those heavy tanks on these maps that have narrow hulls.
Oh, yes,
you need that firepower. You don't need the mobility as much. And, let's see what happens, man. Can Noah start to turn this around, or is Arete going to now go up 2-0? By the way, we can have draws.
Yes,
it is possible if we don't have one team with a Tier 8 advantage by the end. All right, game number two is ready to go, so let's get ready here with Noah against Arete here at GOM EXP. Alright, so we have Arete here in the north, and now in the south is Noah. Arete winning that previous game. They are the defending champions from Season 1. In the open season, it was Noah that was the champions. Noah did lose to Arete in the finals of last season. So we have the two best, undisputably, the two best World of Tank teams in the country. Oh my God!
Huge mistake.
Fender Bender here. In the finals, that's not supposed to happen. That's actually a shocker. Yeah, guys, when you have a Tier 8, you bump into one of your Tier 1 tanks, the spotters, They will take a lot of damage. I mean, you can actually kill a tier 1 tank by just ramming into it.
Absolutely. And you know what? The fact of the matter is he's going up to the hill, and that hill actually has firefights with T1s, and that little amount of hit points that he lost there actually could make a difference. It's a possibility. So we'll see, Tusu. He only took 9 damage, so it's not like the biggest deal, but still, it's a little bit surprising at least.
Well, let's see if this actually plays out here.
Imagine if Tusu dies when his opponent has 8 hit points, how bad everyone's going to feel.
Well, we have the 2 tier 1s here going up on the far right side of the map in the 0 file.
Now, Arate's Sod has already died.
What?
I didn't even see where that happened. I'm very confused.
Do we know where the corpse is?
Corpse? The dead tank?
Yeah, man. Rotting tank corpse?
I don't know.
Vultures flying over it?
Yeah, maybe...
Robot vultures?
Robot vultures over the tank corpse?
Yeah, man.
In medieval Europe? Or, well, not medieval, but 1940s
Europe
or something.
Me made this game.
Yeah.
Now... actually, that's weird. How the hell did an SOD die?
You know, I'm not exactly sure, but let's see here. Evenfall going way up towards the flag right now of his opponents. Just a very defensive posture for Arate.
We do have a standoff here at the chapel, far right side of the map on the high ground here. And we do have, I believe it's the AMX 5100 for Arate coming up here to try to pick off that T1, but now backing up and going down.
Rightfully so. Noah is starting to move into position. You know, Herb and Artie World actually moving up the side of those train tracks. Evenfall is spotted quite far up for them. So 3 heavies going up while 2 sit in the middle down south to try to snipe anyone that comes out.
Now, Arate is actually backing up and leaving their flag a little bit open to try to tempt Noah. It looks like to perhaps attempt to occupy that while their sights are all focused on that area. So they're trying to bait in the Team Noah. Mm-hmm. We'll see how effective they are at that. But Arate is in a little bit of a peculiar defensive spot, most likely because for some reason Saad died. Meanwhile, by the way, Tusu was bumped into. So Arate actually off to a very shockingly bumpy start considering their reputation.
Indeed. It's a tough spot. So do they just turtle out from here because of that? You know, the turtling can... you do have an advantage as defenders.
That's true.
If you do it right. You know, as long as you don't let them get a huge concave around you, you should be okay.
Togby is going to have to be careful up there. Mm. In that rubble inside that building because... Oh, wait, hold on. I think we have... We almost had an engagement there with the T1s on the far right.
They definitely saw each other at least. Yep. Doesn't look like either of them have died, so that's good at least. It's Arate continuing to turtle. Noah continuing to move up on that left side of the map. The 1-2 line.
The countdown timer is now at 6 minutes 45 seconds. Pick Thief and Candy have spotted each other. Togi is there as well. I don't know if Candy's going to go any further. Mm. Noah is itching right now, as you can see on the mini-map, to push in through that middle alleyway. And in fact... If Noah did that, it could be very effective because Arate doesn't even have a counterattack strategy, although Noah doesn't know that.
Well, they are going back. Oh, my God. Yeah, they're getting ready for that move because Candy's kind of holding this area right now, just waiting for Pig Thief to move out back towards the flag. Red Bull sees his prey, the flag area. Get in there?
I think Noah might end up taking this one.
It could
be. I mean, considering the weird start and then the fact that Noah looks like they're pretty geared up to actually... push in here.
Well,
I like the spot though here for Christina. Look at that. Mm-hmm. If they try to take that flag area, that AMX 5100 is going to be able to do a lot of damage to those other tanks.
Mm, certainly a tough one. You know, 3 of these big heavy tanks for Arate are right in that middle area, right around, you know, in that D line. So
it looks like what they want to do is they want to have Noah and attempt to do the base capture, and then they're going to come up, head northbound through that alley. Slightly to the left in 5 lane. They're going to go up that and I think hit him from there.
I think they're going to try to have 3 tanks take the flag and then another couple tanks try to hold that alley that Pig Thief is down. Because there are so many tanks down there and punish them if they try to run back towards that flag. Because when you have 3 tanks on the flag, it goes down so quickly. So quickly.
All right. Candy is actually going to go around. They're going to go through the plaza area. This is basically the only open area on this map. Mm.
Evenfall going to scout it out. Never afraid to die.
Yeah, well, this is, you know, evidence that Evenfall is actually a great team captain. He knows his role here. Not to get kills, but to spot for everybody else so that they can get kills. Now, he sees that 5 lane is actually cleared. So now he's going to peek around here. Now, here he might actually be able to spot Togi. And I believe the other tank there was Christina.
There's definitely Pig Thief there as well.
Pig Thief there. There might be Togian Pig Thief. Excuse me.
So look at this. Yeah, they are moving around into a very sneaky location that is not going to be expected. And look at that. Suddenly, Arete is starting to move.
Wait, we got a kill here. Noah killed that T1.
Could be an issue. Cow Thief and Pig Thief.
It's now 5v7. Tense game here as Noah's starting to sneak up on these other tanks.
A little bit of bumping going on. Noah
pushing
forward.
Bumping and grinding.
We're
in the club.
Shoot, Papa.
Oh, wait. Pig Thief could be shot through this archway.
Yeah, Candy is coming up from the side.
Pig Thief is none the wiser to this right now.
Yeah, he's just trying to hold these guys back.
But Cow Thief is going to come around here and cover.
Actually, Candy could be in some trouble. Candy might get crushed here, Tasis. Red Bull taking a big hit from Pig Thief.
Shield Papa now going to try to come around here. Actually, Arte's handling this quite well, considering.
Yeah.
Okay, now we have one T1 going to come up here and occupy. Wait, not just yet. A base capture is now started.
Oh, Cow Thief trying to go for Candy.
Cow Thief coming around. Nano now pushing forward here.
Arte has decided it is time to make something happen here. They're starting to come around from the sides. Nano going up the other side as well.
And more shots fired. Togi now being forced to back up here. Candy being pushed back here as Christina and Cow Thief press forward. But now they're backing up. Christina taking out. Where the hell did that shot even come from?
I don't even know. That was absolutely crazy.
I don't even know how they got killed.
Noah has so many tanks left.
Red Bull's at 4 HP here. He's going to back up. It's very important to keep Red Bull's life for as long as possible.
Artie World takes down Pig Thief. That's a big kill right there. One of the best players on their team. The flag has been captured.
It's
but
Red Bull and Shio Papa now. Herb now meeting up with him. Shio Papa taken out. And look at this, Cow Thief goes right across that open area towards Herb, knowing he just has more HP. Actually moves past him, because there's only 10 more seconds here before this base capture occurs.
In fact, Nano being hunted down by Artie World.
He has
to get
a kill on these tanks over here in the next 5 seconds.
It has to
happen.
He's
coming out 3, 2, takes him out in the last second to reset that.
1 second remaining. Now, Artie World, though, still behind them, trying to shoot him. Does have to back up. Absolute madness. We only have Cow Thief and Nano left against Artie World. Oh my god.
Artie World now being closed in on. Cow Thief is not taking any damage. Cow Thief ends this here. Beautiful play.
What?
With a save at the last second there.
Arete can't be beaten. This is going to be a 4-0.
I could not believe that. The decisive move there for Cow Thief
to see him
go
run
through,
by.
Through that entire area. Past all the other tanks taking fire. I guess I should say dodging fire.
Yeah.
All the other bullets, all the other shells bounce and
I
miss.
Feel like I just watched the beginning of Dances with Wolves again, where he goes out to die and just doesn't get hit like 5 times and gets a medal. It's like,
he
what
got
did
there
I just see?
With a second left.
Crazy.
Blew up that
literally
T1.
1 second
literally
left.
1 second. And it got to zero. And he fired. Once it hits that zero marker, the game ends. And you can see the frustration here on Noah.
They killed both T1s. They were actually 10 tiers ahead for a portion.
Beyond that, even Arte, within the first few seconds, Bender there, bumping into one of their own T1s and damaging it.
Yeah, and losing that sod right off the bat. Like, the fact that they're still pulling out these wins, Tasteless, when they are behind, it's insane. Arte, they feel way too strong.
Yeah, that was an incredible game. That was actually, I think, probably one of the best World of Tanks games we ever casted.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Well,
it got so crazy there at the end. In fact, both these games have been really good so far.
Yeah. We're going to go to a short little break. We come back. We're going to continue the finals here to see if Arte is going to win this or if Noah's going to come back here at GOM EXP.